اللهم احفظنا من الشرور والآثام والوباء والأمراض. نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين، واجعلنا من التوابين، واجعلنا من المتطهرين، واجعلنا من ورثة جنة النعيم. آمين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him for all His blessings. And we thank Him all the time. Even in times of calamities, we act patiently and thank Him. Thank Him for the things we have. And ask Him for the things we don't have. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. Protect this country, protect the people, protect all the Muslims around the world, and all humanity from this pandemic. We will witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and we will witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is His servant and messenger. Just as an introduction, and this khutbah will be very short for the sake of making the announcements and prepare us for the days and the weeks ahead. My worry number one now, I am not worried about the pandemic. I am not worried about the pandemic. I am not worried about the pandemic. I am worried about the panic. I am worried about the panic. I am worried about the panic. It's not about the pandemic, it's the panic. As I said earlier, at least your father or mother or grandfather in their lifetime, they experience far worse things. In China, in Africa, in India, in many places around the world, South America, even here, they had plagues and diseases and viruses. And they lived, and you are here, their children and grandchildren. Today, science is advanced. Because they're telling us to be cautious, it doesn't mean that we are going to be sick. The mindset now is becoming so refreshed. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ مَنُوعًا. We human beings, you know, we freak out, we're hasty. Come on, practice salat. When Allah says, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ. Establish prayer, connection with Allah and dhikr. It will prevent you from going and doing wrong, including panicking. What's going on with our society? We need to calm down. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. For the sake of time and the sake of safety, all this khutbah today is actually already posted on our website, already posted on Facebook. You'll find it, share it. It gives you this, and the khutbah last week that gives you guidelines, and the one before that gives you the du'as. Please refer to our website and refer to this. I have put everything. I have started since I was in Umrah at the end of January when I saw something is coming. And you can refer to that video. And I say the dua in it. My brothers and sisters, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَنْ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Say, O Muhammad, teach them until the day of judgment. your followers, they should always say, nothing will happen to us except what Allah has decreed for us. One of the pillars of Iman, yu'minu bil qadari khayri wa sharri. We can do things, we have to do them. In Islam, we take precaution. If we have to suspend Jum'ah next week and the week after, we'll. There's no need. You know, it's okay. Don't worry, Islam is bigger than that. So next week there will be no Jum'ah. It's fine. Or the week after. It's fine. You can pray from home. We will provide an online service all the time, even at Jum'ah time. So you can be with us and pray. Allah knows our intention. We do what we can, but if you are in the middle of a rock, in a mountain, in a cave, in a remote desert, or in the Rocky Mountains, and it's meant for you to have the coronavirus, you're gonna have it. There is no, but if it's, you do what you can and leave the rest to Allah. He says, Allah, nothing will happen to us except what has been decreed. Allah decreed for us. He is our protector. And on Allah, let the believers, Muhammad, tell them to put their trust in Him. My brothers and sisters, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, احفظ الله تجد أمامك تعرف على الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة واعلم أن ما أصابك ما أخطأك لم يكن ليصيبك ما أخطأك لم يكن ليصيبك وما أصابك لم يكن ليخطئك واعلم أن النصر مع الصبر وأن الفرج مع الكرب وأن مع العسر يسرا. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم teaches that in the hadith that he's teaching his cousin Ibn Abbas, he's telling him, be mindful of Allah. Please be mindful of Allah. You shall find Him in front of you. Know Allah in times of prosperity. I know you. You always donate. You always visit the sick. You take care of your parents. Don't worry. Allah knows you in times of hardship. And really, it's not that hardship. It's only a flu. No need to panic. And only 1%, according to the numbers, who die out of it. And the regular seasonal flu kills more people. And actually TB, tuberculosis, kills more. What's the panic for? Just a precaution. Please, let's make a difference as believers in Allah. We're not scared, but we take the means. Please, let's not act like everybody's panicking. What is going on? What is going on? He says, know Allah in times of prosperity, He will know in times of hardship. Know that whatever passed you, what passed you could never have happened, and what happened could never have been avoided. Know that victory comes with patience, relief comes with affliction, and with hardship comes ease. So let's do what we can and leave the rest to. To whom? I want to hear His name.
Allah.
I want to hear His name.
Allah.
I want to hear His name.
Allah.
Why do we say Allahu Akbar? This virus, 5 million times smaller than each one of us, which is 5 million smaller, asgharu minna. And we forget the one who is akbaru minna wa minna jameer. We forget. We are worried about the little thing that is 5 million times smaller than us. And we forget the one that is bigger than everybody and everything. Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Repeat Allahu Akbar at home so your children can grow up with Allahu Akbar. So, to wrap up, what can we do? Here are some kind reminders that you find them posted. Please pray and don't panic. The one who has permitted for the disease to come out can surely take it away. Number two, wash your hands with warm water and make wudu as often as you can. Please refer to the khutbas of the last few weeks. They have everything you need. Disinfect and clean your phone. This phone, you take it. Some people take it to the washroom. Some people take it everywhere and they forget. This phone is actually playing a big role in spreading the disease. Disinfect it. Be in touch with your love. Drink a lot of warm water. Disinfect your phone, your PC, your laptop, keyboard, wallet, glasses, all the things that you use, part of you, accessories. Eat healthy and less sugar, because it reduces immunity. If you can fast a little bit, we'll do intermittent fasting, do it. Fasting will help. Actually, eat less, you feel more energetic. Because the more food, the more we digest, the more we put our body under hardship and stress. Eat less, lesser. Maybe we're going to lose weight during this pandemic. Huh? We never know. Maybe we'll gain weight. Maybe we'll become healthier. But eat moderate. Eat moderate. And appreciate the good things we have. Drink a lot of warm water. Don't drink no more cold water. Don't drink cold water. Cold water is no good. Drink warm water. You know, green tea, things that are this. Drink, alhamdulillah. Enjoy, alhamdulillah, this country is blessed with a lot of fresh water. Drink water. If you want to boil it and then let it cool down a little bit and drink it, it's even better. Spend quality time with your family. This is the time now you're home. Spend quality time. I know it's going to be challenging for the parents. They're already talking March break. Sorry. Go to the park. Go to the park. Nobody stops you. They're not telling you go to in the air, huh? Outside. Go and enjoy nature. Subhanallah. And spring is coming soon. Allahu Akbar. It didn't happen in December or January. It was very cold. Alhamdulillah. Spend quality time with your family. Be in touch with your loved ones. But practice social distancing. Social distancing. We're doing it here. There's 4 feet between each one. Each and every one. Why did we make you sit? Even Salat, you're going to pray as you are. Even Salat, I want you to pray. Yeah. Oh, we never did it. Ya Habibi, it's better than. So, because some may have it. One person may have it. We don't know. Inshallah not. But keep. We're going to pray separate from each other. You know, in the masjid we've been praying in different places for the last couple of weeks. Every Salat we pray in different places. Alhamdulillah, Allah blessed us with space. You know, some places cannot, but they shut down. But we pray in different Salat, different places, just to play with this virus, because this virus cannot live except in a living being. And it doesn't have a cell, it's not a cell. That means it depends on other life. And on porous areas doesn't live long. It's a matter of hours, maximum a day. And hard surfaces, metal, vinyl, glass, it lives longer. But if you go around it and teach your children, everybody not flood. Children need guidance. Yes, they're not affected by it, but they are also carriers, dangerous carriers. And it's wise that the government has suspended school until further notice or until 2 weeks after. It's a wise thing. Alhamdulillah, we have online, so education, if you really want to learn, you can learn at home. You know, this is very important. Okay, so although social distancing is disruptive and economically, financially damaging, yeah, we may lose some business, maybe stock market, who cares? I'm not going to lose my life. We appreciate life now. It will certainly, social distancing will certainly help us save lives, inshallah. Stay home when sick and even when you want to go to pray. It's better. God understands your situation. God understands better. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ مَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيَجْعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ Allah would never want to put you in difficulty. Allah would never want to put you in hardship. Allah said that. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُخَفِفَ عَنْكُمْ وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا Allah wants to make things easy for you. You were made weak, vulnerable. We are very weak as a being, as a human being. So my brothers and sisters, yes, it's okay not to pray Jumu'ah. Brothers, please, social distancing, don't say. Nobody, please, we set up the line always. Please, those come late, stay there at the back. Brothers, close the door if we have reached the 200 number. La ilaha illallah. We need your cooperation. Volunteers, please. Father, help us, please. Keep distance. Allah says He doesn't want difficulty for you. قُطَّاهَا مَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لِتَشْقَى Allah took it to Muhammad and said, we did not send the Quran to make life difficult for you or sad. It's not. It's to make it easy Islam is about enhancing life. That's why our organization, Faith of Life, is about enhancing life, celebrating life, sustaining and keeping and making it better. Allah has not imposed any difficulties on you in this deen of Islam, He says in chapter 22, 78, and also in chapter 5. وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ مِنَ التَّهْلُكَةِ وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And make not your own hands contribute to your destruction, but do good, for Allah loves those who do good. The Prophet ﷺ said, لا ضرر ولا ضرار. You all know this hadith. No harming and no causing harm for others. There should be neither harming, darar, nor reciprocating harm, darar. This is very important. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that a beautiful hadith. لا يورد ممرض على مصح. A person who is close to a disease. They used to have people with camels that have disease like leprosy. It's for animals. Jarab. And they used to have camels that are healthy. So Rasulullah said, don't take the camels that are unhealthy closer to the camels that are healthy. And the person who is close to them should not go to the person who is close to the healthy animals. What does it mean? 1400 years ago, your beloved Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it 1400 years ago. He said, if you have disease, do not carry it to those who are not sick. So we're going to practice that, inshallah. And also, and we mentioned this hadith many times, refer to it. Nabi said, if you hear of it, meaning the ta'un virus, whatever disease, plague, do not go to it, that country. And if you are in that country, do not come out of it. So we have everything in Islam. We have everything in Islam. Inshallah, we stay safe. We have reduced the timing for Salat. We have reduced everything. We will, the center is operating. We are in the office. If you have question, email. The phone is ringing as I'm speaking non-stop. How can we answer phone at 3 a.m.? People calling. Who's going to answer phone at 3 a.m.? We need to go to sleep. 3 a.m. is sleeping. So please, email if it's necessary. And I repeat, as I said in the announcement, anybody, anyone in this community who falls sick and doesn't have no relatives, nobody, no neighbors, we are your neighbors. We are your family. Sayyida Khadija Center, myself personally, inshallah, if I'm healthy, and my team, emergency team, we will do shopping for you. You need medicine, but I cannot do it for GTA Muslim community. I cannot do it for all. We are, mashallah, 750,000 Muslims. I will do it for Sayyida Khadija Center Jama'ah. If every imam takes care of his Jama'ah, every community looks after each other, we won't have a problem. This is the concept of Islam, of Jama'ah. Stick to your Jama'ah and inshallah, reduce. Brothers and sisters, inshallah, next week and the week after, no Jumu'ah. Okay, no Jumu'ah. I will be giving speech. I will be with a few people. I will do Jumu'ah. Maybe I'll do it outside, I don't know. Check with me in email, I don't know. But we will not hold Jumu'ah. Elderly people, please stay home. Sisters, you have children, stay home. But we will be there. Now, inshallah, you can talk. Some of you were asking about the food. We will make announcements after Jumu'ah about something. But support the food. We apply strict peer region guidelines. And we work with them when it comes to safety. You can buy and support the center. We will, inshallah, talk and make announcement after Jumu'ah. نفعني الله وإياكم القرآن العظيم وبسنة نبينا محمد عليه أفضل الصلاة والتسليم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين عبد رسوله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل وسلم وبارك عليه في الآخرين وصل وسلم وبارك عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. عدد معلوماتك ومداد كلماتك كلما ذكرك الذاكرون. وغفل عن ذكرك الغافلون. اللهم اشفنا وعافنا واعف عنا. اللهم اذهب الداء واذهب الوباء وانزل الشفاء، فانك ما انزلت من داء الا انزلت له الدواء. اللهم اذهب عنا عضال الداء. اللهم نعوذ بك من عضال الداء ومن شماتة الاعداء ومن السلب بعد العطاء. اللهم اشفنا يا شافي، واكفنا يا كافي، وعافنا يا معافي. اللهم احفظ مشايخنا، واحفظ اباءنا وامهاتنا احياء. اللهم اغفر لهم امواتا. اللهم ان امتنا فامتنا وانت راض عنا. اللهم ارحمنا فانك بنا راحم، ولا تعذبنا فانك علينا قادر. يا لطيف 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 الطف بنا. يا لطيف الطف بنا، يا رحيم ارحمنا، يا كريم اكرمنا، يا ستار استرنا. اللهم انا تبنا اليك. استغفر الله العظيم الذي لا اله الا هو الحي القيوم واتوب اليه. اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم احفظ جميع. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from all ailments and diseases. May Allah enable us to follow the instructions of our leaders and our health officials, and we cooperate with them. But we should stick together more. Now we're going to appreciate each other more. We're going to miss each other. But inshallah, we will pray for each other and keep in touch with all the means we have. Allahumma aghfir lana wa li walidina wa jami' al muslimina wa muslimat, mu'mina wa mu'minat, ahya' min amwat, innaka sami' al mujib al da'wat. May Allah be with those countries that are affected and they may not have the means we have. May Allah make it easy for them. And our brothers and sisters in all our back homes where we come from, you know, those of us who are immigrants, you may have relatives. Please give them this message and ask them to practice social distancing. And it's very, very easy. They can also make nationalism affected, inshallah. It's not, it's all about cleanliness and prevention. Allahumma kun al muslimina fi jami' bilad al muslimin. Kun al muslimina fi jami' bilad al muslimin. Allahumma kun al muslimina fi jami' bilad al muslimin. Wal muslimina fi kulli makan. Ya hannan ya mannan. Allahumma kun al muslimina fi Palestine, fi Sham, fi Iraq. المسلمين في بورما وكشمير وتركستان، والمسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم كن معنا ولا تكن علينا. اللهم كن مع المسلمين في الهند. اللهم كن مع المسلمين في كندا يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ هذا البلد من داء، ووفق ولاة امره على العمل على ما هو فيه نفع للبلاد والعباد. امين امين. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.